lesson, that is Introduction to the Parliamentary System. In this chapter, we are going to learn machineries or the system of government as given in the Indian Constitution. Have you thought of this? What is a parliamentary system? In India, we have a Prime Minister, but why is there no Prime Minister in the United States of America? What is the difference between a presidential and a parliamentary system?
These questions would lead us to conclude that every country has a different form of government. Before we go ahead to understand different types of government systems, let us get information about the main branches of government. The functions of legislature is to make law. The executive implements the law. And the judiciary provides justice. The functions of these organs, their jurisdiction and limitations on their power and the interrelationship between these organs are decided by the Constitution. There are two main types of government system that are followed: parliamentary system and presidential system. The parliamentary system of government developed primarily in England. The English Constitution is an unwritten constitution. The governance is carried out in accordance with the traditions and customs and conventions. India has adopted this parliamentary system. We can see some broad similarities in the parliamentary system of England and the parliamentary system of India. But when looked at an institutional level, the Indian parliamentary system is different in its content. Let us understand the characteristic of the Indian parliamentary system of government in India. The parliamentary system is a system of governance. The legislature of the central government is known as the parliament. The Indian Parliament is composed of President, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. The numbers of members in the House is fixed. Elections to the Lok Sabha are held at regular intervals. All political parties contest these elections. The party which gets more than half of the seats is considered as the majority party. The majority party forms the government. Sometimes when no party gets a clear majority, some parties come together to form a majority and they can establish the government. This kind of a government is known as a coalition government. In this way, candidates directly elected by people became members of the legislature and the party in majority gets a chance to form the government. The leader of the majority party becomes the prime minister. He or she selects candidates for ministerial positions from among his or her colleagues. The Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers chosen by the Prime Minister together form the executive in the parliamentary system of government. In parliamentary system, the executive has a dual responsibility. First, as an executive, they have to implement law. Second, as they are members of the legislature, they also have to fulfill responsibilities of the legislature. The Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers is responsible to the legislature for all their actions and policies. It means that the Council of Ministers has to work with the legislature. It is for this reason that the parliamentary system is known as responsible system of government. Another distinct characteristic of parliamentary system of government is collective responsibility. Decision taken by any minister or department is considered as decision of the government. The entire council of ministers is responsible for the decision. India adopted the parliamentary system of government for several reasons. The development of parliamentary institution started during the British rule. The British rulers governed in accordance with this system. The parliamentary system of government in India is also in a way of product of the freedom movement. Indians were familiar to this system of government. The framers of the constitution made few changes in the parliamentary system to suit the Indian
situation. We will see presidential system of government. Presidential system of government can be said to be another important system of government. This type of system exists in countries such as
United States of America.
This system is different from the parliamentary form. In this system, the president is the executive and is dependent of the legislature, and as the head of the state, the president is directly elected by people. So, my dear students, here are some points of differentiate between a parliamentary and a presidential system of government. So by seeing, you are able to understand what is the differentiate between.
So my dear students, I hope you understood all this parliamentary system. So next topic we will see in next video.